Hello friends, welcome to my next video tutorial of multi-storied steel structure analysis and design in Staad Pro version V8i. In this particular video tutorial series, I'm going to show you how to define member like column, beam, slab, bracing, and then how to assign them in the 3D model. And in this particular project, I'm using build-up section, and if you have hotel section, then you can also use from the various country available. Going to here the section database, you can set lots of member size as per various building code available here, and from here you can use different kind of size and shape you want. But I'm not going to use this, just I will use for my bracing a hot roll section, which is a tube. I will show you later. First I am going to show you how to define build up section, and as per my this model, I am just assuming some variable column size and various beam and bracing size. So for my column, I'm assuming a similar size for my this interior column, and another size for my side column, and another size for my corner column. So totally I am going to define three size for my column. So to define, go to here, define, then here tapered one. From here, first define for my interior column, which might be say 0.45 is 450, then thickness of web say 0.01, which is 10 mm, and depth of the section at end, this is also 445, then width of the top flange say 0.25 is 250, and thickness of the top flange say 0.012, which is 12 mm. And for the width of bottom flange and thickness of bottom flange, you might skip. If you put here 0, then it will count this same value for this cells. So after you have inputted all this value, then click add. So my first column definition is done. The second I am going to define for my side column. This is 0.8 and this is 10 mm. Add next my corner column, say this is 6 mm and this is 8 mm. Add. Okay, now I have main beam. So for my column, this red beam here, you can see this is the red color, so this is my main beam. So I'm defining this main beam as 450, 8 mm, 450, this is 200, and this is 10 mm. Add. Okay, I have also main beam in the opposite direction like this. You can see this red color beam, this red color. So I'm defining for my main beam in the other direction, say 350 6 mm, 350, then this is say 150, and this say 8 mm. Add. Okay, the last one, I have the sub beam. As you see, this is the blue color, which are my sub beam. So the sub beam might be 300, this is 5 mm, 300 150, say this is 6 mm. Add. Close. So my variable column and beam size definition is done. Now I have to define a hot roll section for my this bracings. So go to here section database. From here I am just using say British and tube, and I want to use 100 105 mm thick tube. Find from here this one, 100 105. Click here add. You can use from anywhere among these codes, it will not affect your design, and you will just write this name as per your local practice, and you can use from any member from any one of this code. So close this one, and now I have to assign them in the model. So to assign, select first this number one, and now I want to assign them for my interior column. So to select my interior column, I can just go to here select, then beam parallel to say Y. So all column has been selected. Right click, now new view, check the second one. Okay, now go to here, from your top view press shift then K. Okay, now select this way, all these are my interior beam. go to here, this isometric view to check. Yes, I have selected all this interior. Now from here, check this assign to selected beams. Now click assign. Yes, okay. Same way, go to this top view from here, view from plus Y. Now from here, select the taper 2, select all these, hold down the control key, select this way and this way. Now check going to here, okay, selected. Now assign, okay, select the third one is for my this four columns at the corner, select this way. Now assign, yes. So all my column assign is done. If you want to check, you can go to here, this symbol, symbols and labels, from here structures, full sections, apply, okay. Now you can check. So all my column is in this direction here, but if I go to my model, I have all the column which is vertically oriented, but here they are in horizontally oriented. So I have to change the orientation of these columns. I can do by creating here beta angle. Go to here beta angle, click here, create beta angle 90 degree, okay. Now select this beta angle and select all these columns and assign, yes. Now you can see all the column is now rotated, and now this is as per my AutoCAD file here, okay. Now click here this icon, display whole structure from here, and go to here this view from plus Z and select all this, or go to here this top view, and from here the fourth one is for my main beam. So if I want to select my main beam, I have to select, I can select them in various way by going to here view from Z, select all this top beam, right click, new view, okay. Now go to the top view, and from here now you can select this way by dragging your mouse this way, press control, hold down the control and select this way, this way, this way, this way, and now assign, yes. This one is my main beam in the opposite direction, and I can select that from this line and also this line, and assign, yes, hold, okay. Now you can see all my main beam assign is done. Now if I want to assign for my other beam, same way I can do, go to here, select this, right click, new view, okay, top view, and select this last one, which is the sixth one, and from here by dragging your mouse this way, you can select, hold down the control key, select carefully this way, this way, this way, here, okay. Similarly, select all these beams. Now click here assign, okay, done. Go to here this display hole model. Now I have only the bracing else, so I'm going to here select this seventh member, go to here select, and from here by missing attribute, missing properties, so all my bracing has been selected. Now click assign, yes, okay, done. So if you see, all my member assign is done, and I'm not assigning any support right now. I will assign when I have completed this up to 5-story model, then I will assign my support. It is not important in right now. And now I'm going to show you for my this sub beam, I have different type of connection. So in case of steel structure, you have variable type of connection. Some are moment resisting and some are only taking shear force. So you need to know which support will take moment and which support will not take moment, only shear. So the beam connected with column directly is going to be moment connection, and any beam connecting to other beam will be shear connection. So all of this my sub beam will be connected with this main beam, and this connection will be shear connection type. If you check this image, here is a, this is main beam and this is my sub beam. This will be connected with angle or some cleat and also nut and bolt. This is a kind of shear connection. So you have to specify here, this is a shear connection type. otherwise it will count as a moment connection type by default. So to change the connection type, select any beam, say this one, double click on this, click at this icon, change release at start. From here going to check this partial moment release, click here MPZ, say 0.95. so I'm releasing 95%. 100% is not 100% is not possible, because practically there will be some moment, so you cannot reduce 100%. That's why I'm just doing 95%. Now click add, click the next one, change release at end. Same way, check this one, partial moment release, check this MPZ, this is 0.95, add, close. Now you can see two circle has been drawn at the end of this two beam, at this end and also this end. So this end of this beam is now released of moment, so it will take only shear force. And I have to do this for all my sub beam. To do that, go to here general, then click here spec and select this one. And before that, you have to select all this beam, all of your sub beams. To select all sub beams, go to here geometry general, and then from here select this six beam. Now go to here spec, select this one. Now press control, deselect this one. Now make sure you have assigned to selected beams. Assign, yes. Select the next one and assign, yes. So now you can see all my sub beam is moment released. So okay. And for my this bracing, I have to define them as trusses, because it will take only tension on compression. To do that, I have to go to here spec from this left side list. Now from here click this beam, from this specification whole structure beam, and click here truss and click add. Now truss has been added. Now go to here general and select all this, then specs again, select this truss, assign to selected beams, assign, yes. So done. So I have completed assigning of all members like column, beam, sub beam and bracing too. And now I have to define for the slab. And to define slab, as you see in this image, I have this type of floor slab with a steel decking, then I have a concrete slab casting with rebar. So to here I have a total thickness of 125 mm from the bottom of the rib to the top of the slab. And for this rib, I am just defining an average of 100 mm slab. To define the slab thickness, click here thickness, and here 0.1, add, close. And from here take this add node and click here 4 point where the column is. So my panel is surrounded by my main beam, so I am just picking 4 point, this one point corner, this corner and this corner. So by picking 4 corner, I am adding plates. This do for all the panels. After you have drawn all the plate outline, then from here take this plate cursor and select all these plates this way, and select this plate thickness, then click here assign. Make sure you have assigned to selected plates, assign, yes. Now click here this icon, start editor, write density, press enter. Now here you can find density, just change this density, copy from this alpha 1.2e to the power point 0.005, copy this, paste that here, replace 76.8195 and change this to 1e, this is minus 5 is 32. So I am just neglecting the weight of the concrete. I don't want to add the concrete weight here. I will use load for the concrete weight. I am just assigning the slab here to increase the stiffness of the building, so I am not taking account with this weight. So save this one. So the density 1e to the power minus 0.0032 means that you are ignoring the weight of this slab. Now close this one down. So this way you can define various member and also assign various member in your Staad Pro model. So thanks for watching my this video. See you in the next video.